Hi, this is CAD/CAM Lessons channel, and in this video I will briefly discuss the differences between the part and part design modules available in FreeCAD. Both modules allow for creating 3D models. In both the part and part design modules we can create a 3D solid, and in many cases it can be the same solid. We can create the same solid in both modules. However, these modules have entirely different design approach. The part module uses an approach based on constructive solid geometry, where we build 3D models from geometric primitives and Boolean operations. We create individual independent solid objects that we can combine. Now I will show you a simple example of such modeling. I have the part module. Create a new project, and we have simple shapes here. I will create a cube and specify its dimensions: length 100 millimeters, width 70, and height 5 millimeters. Okay, and we have created such a plate. We created this solid by selecting a basic shape and adding dimensions. Next we can add another shape. I will choose a cylinder. Similarly, specify its dimensions: radius 10 millimeters and height 5 millimeters. Okay, and we have two solids now, and I want this cylinder to be placed inside this plate. We can change the cylinder position by selecting it and looking for the placement parameter in the property window. We can change the cylinder positions by rotating the mouse wheel or entering a specific value. I will set the position in the x-axis to 30 and the position in the y-axis to 25 millimeters, and we have two solids. And if I want to get a plate with a hole, I can apply a subtraction operation. Select the plate, select the cylinder with the control key, and choose cut operation. And we have created a plate with a hole. I can create another shape. For example, another cube, and specifying its dimension: length 30 millimeters, width 20 millimeters, and height 10 millimeters, and move this cube along x-axis by 50 millimeters. Leave the y position as it is and move it up by 5 millimeters on the Z axis. Now we have something like this. We have a solid created by subtracting one shape from another, and we created another shape. We can combine these two solids into one. Select both solids with the control key and choose the union operation. At this point, it is a single solid, and notice the history of creating these solids. Everything is within this single solid, and we have the shapes used to create this solid. This is roughly how we work in the part module. On the other hand, the part design module uses feature-based parametric modeling, starting with a base feature and sequentially adding other features. We work within a single solid, building features and creating a modeling history. Now I will switch to the part design module. I have another FreeCAD window open. Create a new project in part design, and to create a plate with a hole as before, in part design we work with sketches and solid operations. First, create a sketch. Select XY plane, draw a rectangle, and specify its dimensions: here 100 millimeters and here 70. Okay. And close the sketch, and based on this sketch, create a plate with a height of 5 millimeters. Okay. Let's create another sketch for the hole and create a circle. And I will not dimension this sketch, close the sketch and add a pocket operation. And we have a plate with a hole similar to the part module. I can also create the hole directly in the sketch. I will delete this operation and I will delete this sketch, and I can create a hole in this sketch. Let's edit this sketch and I create a circle here, and let's add dimensions. Circle radius 10 millimeters. So I choose constraint radius, select circle and enter here 10 millimeters. And the distance from this point 30 millimeters, and from this point 25 millimeters. Okay, close the sketch, and we have a plate with a hole like in the part module. This is the part operation which consists the sketch. Now let's create another part of the 3D solid similar to the part module, and let's create a new sketch on this face. Draw a rectangle, for example like this. And note the constraints in the part design module. An automatic constraint has placed this point on the X axis. So the rectangle is constrained to the X axis. I can move this rectangle only along the X axis. I cannot move it up or down, only left or right until dimensions are added. And specify the rectangle's dimensions, here 30 millimeters and here 20 millimeters. Okay, and set the distance from this point to 50 millimeters. Okay, close the sketch and add another extrusion, for example 20 millimeters. Okay. And we have something similar to what we created in the part module. And all added operations are displayed in the operation history, showing a linear modeling history. We create a base feature, add operation and so on, with everything displayed in the history. The part module uses an approach based on constructive solid geometry, creating complex 3D objects by combining simpler geometric solids using Boolean operations like union, cut or intersection. And the geometric primitives used in this method includes cubes, cylinders, spheres and cones, serving as basic elements for building more complex shapes. This method and working in the part module can be effective for creating shapes composed of simple geometries. The part design module uses a feature-based parametric approach, starting with a simple sketch and transforming it by adding features like extrusions or pockets. This process is more organized and easier to modify, with a coherent and clear modeling history. All operations are recorded in the operation tree, making it easy to trace and modify earlier steps. In this module, we work within a single object, and the entire operation history pertains to a single solid, simplifying project management. Additionally, the parametric approach allows changes made in earlier stages to automatically update all subsequent features. For example, changing the extrusion height to 25 millimeters applies changes to the solid, and subsequent operations adjust accordingly. In FreeCAD, we can modify dimensions of earlier operations, facilitating corrections and solid modifications. If a prototype reveals the need for adjustment, such as resizing a hole, it can be easily changed without recreating the solid. For instance, edit the sketch and change the hole radius to 15 millimeters. Close the sketch and the hole in the solid updates. The part design module is suitable for creating mechanical parts intended for production. When starting 3D model, I prefer the part design module as I find it more suitable than the part module. However, in FreeCAD we can use different modules within a single project, creating a solid using both part and part design modules. This approach requires attention, as editing earlier stages of the 3D solid may become difficult or impossible. In this video, I wanted to briefly show the differences between these two modules, demonstrating the basic principles of creating 3D solids in the part and part design modules. I hope this gives you an understanding of fundamental differences between these modules. And that's all for today, thanks for watching, and if you don't want to miss upcoming videos about FreeCAD, please subscribe to this channel.